Teaching pupils in London's schools is becoming an increasingly tricky business. While the number of different languages used is steadily increasing, the number of pupils not fluent in English has spiralled by about 25% in just 2 years. Now more than 44,000 youngsters are being taught in a language they might not fully understand. Here at the Holland Park Comprehensive, 50 separate languages can regularly be heard, meaning extra help is sometimes needed. There are now 18 specialist teachers like Christine Armstrong, trained to help those for whom English is a second language. They assist the main class teachers in providing some extra help and explanation where necessary.
Our duty is to ensure that all our pupils have equal access to as much of the curriculum as possible and as quickly as possible. So I think the idea that you take them out of the curriculum in order to drill them in English is depriving them of access to the curriculum. But secondly, I think research will show that that's not the way that people acquire English. They acquire it by hearing it spoken around them, by having their peer group speak it, and by joining in with as much confidence as they can.
Yet just welcoming new pupils to Holland Park can be quite a complicated business in itself, let alone getting them to know the rules or where their classes are. Difficulties which all add to the education authorities' cry for more cash.
Any school would claim it could do with more resources. I think at the moment we're using those teachers we have. What's causing me some concern now are the other support services, if you like, that bilingual children need. Their parents, for example, when they come to parent consultation meetings, need translations, need interpreters.
Yet, meanwhile, the teachers make do with the resources they have, convinced that the rich diversity of languages and cultures benefits everyone. Segregation of the pupils, even for English lessons, is kept to a minimum. Marcus Powell for Thames News.